Disclaimer, be advised that I am not a professional financial consultant or advisor. I am sharing this information for education purpose only. Any opinions, news, research, analysis, prices, or other information contained on this video is my own opinion and does not constitute investment advice. I will not accept liability for any loss or damage, including without limitation to any loss of profit, money, asset or any valuables which may arise directly or indirectly from use of information in this video.
Hello, good morning my friends. Welcome to Forex VKS. So let's check out the event first, the news. Yesterday not good for USD, so we see the weakening of USD yesterday. Once GDP below way, below expectation, unemployment claim increase, decrease but below expectation, 382K. Advanced GDP price index is up. Pending home sales, this one, one of the quite important data also. Again drop, which is very, which is not good, not good for the USD. So today we got some USD data, Chicago PMI, core PCI price, and UOM, University of Michigan consumer sentiment, right? So this one we have to wait and see what is the result of a core PCE price index. The expected slight improvement, 0.6. And if this one, if this data come out positive, there could be some change of direction. But currently, we are seeing the USD is weakening. It's weakening. Let's go into the chart. And also take note, today we got a GDP for Canada today. And also German GDP, preliminary GDP. So watch out for this few currency. Okay, let's check out the DXY first. So DXY continue to drop. So for me, right, I'm still looking to buy, to buy the USD as long as it stay above 91.54, if it went below, then we change our bias to sell. So we are still looking to buy, but there is a selling opportunity here, if you guys is aggressive, if the price retrace back to 92.167 and get rejected, there is a short window for sell, but this is counter trend, so we don't trade counter trend, here we trade the conservative way, we trade following the trend, trend following strategy. So this one the trend is still uptrend, until we break this one, our bias line is still uptrend, so we still follow the trend. Euro USD, similar, so our bias line is here. Let me highlight our bias line over here. Wrong. Let me mark it green, so it looks distinctive. So it's still above our bias line, so we are still looking to buy at our resistance to 1.19790, to sell up here. If we get a very good signal, a pin bar over here, possible. But looking at the weakness of the USD, possibly there is still a sell chance over here. You see the price broke through resistance one, right? These are for short term, short term aggressive trader. Once the price come back and retest and resumption, rebound at R1, now it broke through R1. If you come back, rebound at R1, there is a short term buy opportunity towards from resistance 1 to resistance 2, but this is higher risk because this is counter trend, counter trend. our the trend is still structured to the downside, okay, for this until it breaks our bias line, okay, which is R2. USD JPY still very choppy. USD JPY better don't trade. Okay, this one we already lost. Okay, one trade over here and one trade over here. So we lost two trade over this USD JPY. So stay out of it first. Because there are better trend going on. You see these are better trend. Okay, trading this, even trading this counter trend, right? Trading this counter trend toward towards from R1 to R2 is still better than trading the USD JPY here. AUD USD is still okay. Both currencies weak. AUD is weak. USD is weak. So we are still in the sideways market. So nothing much we can do. Okay. Possible if we got a strong pin bar over here at resistance one. Okay. We might want to sell it to support one. Or okay, the price goes through resistance one, comes to resistance two. Okay, and a rejection over here. Okay, we want to possible want to sell. Or the price breakthrough support to retest resumption, okay, to the downside, then we want to sell. Okay, we are still looking to sell. But this one we don't see significant retracement. Okay, like a euro USD significant retracement. Okay, possible trend change. This one the trend is still downtrend. Very much structured to the downtrend. USD CAD, so USD CAD trend already changed, okay, towards temporarily, towards a short term downtrend, so so there's a possibility now, okay, for a sell trade over here, okay, due to the weakening of the USD. So if the price, okay, this is for aggressive trader, okay, once the price come back, pull back, okay, to support one, get rejected, okay, then there is a possible sell trade over here, a pin bar over here, okay, or the price goes through support two, okay, and another rejection at support two, there's a possible sell trade, okay, over to, let me label support three, I didn't label support three. To support three, but we don't trade counter trend because by trading the daily candle, okay, if you trade a shorter term 60 minute 4 hours candle, maybe there's a possible there sell trade over here or a sell trade, okay, over here support two or support one. Okay. Pound USD. So it really went through our bias line. Okay. So we are looking to buy now. Okay. Pound USD. Unless the price go back below. Below the. I think the bias line we need to adjust a bit. Here. Okay, so this is more likely now the bias line. Let me mark it green color first, make it distinctive color. Okay, so we wait for a comeback, a retest of resistance 2. Okay, come back. We got a pin bar over here, possible. Okay, a bullish price action at resistance 2. Then we're going to initiate a buy. Okay, the idea of selling has been cancelled once the price actually went through our bias line. Okay, unless the price comes back, okay, below the bias line, then we will change our bias to sell instead. New Zealand dollar USD, New Zealand is still very choppy, so there's nothing much we can do. In the price need to be so need to generate possible a sell opportunity at R1, a big pin buy here, maybe there's selling opportunity to support one, or a break below, okay, retest a break below support one, okay, retest resumption downwards, then we might want to initiate a sell trade. Okay, let's move the gold. Okay, gold now is running sideways between R1 and S1. So what we want to see is a break above R1, retest, resumption. Okay, then we want to initiate a buy trade. Okay, now it's structured to the upside. Once it break through the previous high over here, then the price will be structured to the upside. So we will look for buying opportunity, okay, at our resistance one area. So the index is very choppy, so AUS, AUD, okay, the economy is not doing very well there, okay, so it's choppy. So this one, okay, we want to wait for very clean break, very clean break, come back down, retest resumption only, we will jump in due to the weakness in the Australia economy. So this one a lot of force break, okay, so this one be very very careful, a lot of force break. DEX also similar, okay, DEX is consolidating over here, there's no signal to do anything, okay, so we want to wait a clean signal, a clean break above resistance one, resumption, okay, or the price come back to support one, rebound, okay, or the price come back to support two, rebound. These are the area that, okay, we want to target. Nasdaq similar, cannot go higher, okay, if we can go higher, okay, if we can break the previous high over here possible, okay, there's a buy trade over here, but looks like the price is coming down due to the Fed, okay, the FOMC, right, the statement, right, is came out negative, dovish, okay. Yesterday, okay, remain the same, it cannot break through. So this one, right, we want to wait for a very clean break, okay, then only we will initiate a buy trade. Okay, S&P a clean break, okay, come back retest. Now the price is testing this one, the previous high, okay, so this one, if we can stay above this previous high, okay, this high over here. Okay, so possible there is a buy trade over here. Okay, only SPX, Nasdaq also looks weak. Okay, so SPX you can check out S&P 500, the 1 hour. The retest already being done, okay, came up, retest, okay, then coming up, now already making higher high, okay, looks good. Okay, looks good, but have to be a bit careful, this one. I won't go in with a very big loss size due to the US weakness, US weakness, the weakness in the US data, right? So this one we are have to be careful on this. Even go in also, don't go in too big. So Bitcoin is breaking, trying to break the neckline. So we are very near from breaking to break the neckline. 40,000. Once we stay above 40,000, okay, will be our cue to go in. So now it's trying to break the 40,000 area. Okay, it still haven't. Once it break through, okay, then it's our cue to go in for a second. Our first entry is here. Okay, so this possible second entry. Okay. Once it's break through this one, once it's break through this trend line, will be our third entry over here. Ethereum, okay, our first entry here. Okay, so now we are waiting for the second entry for it to break through this 2389 2004 okay. We want it to break through 2004, stay above 2004, so this is our queue for our second entry. So 2008 we will queue for our third entry to ride the bull market. Litecoin, okay, Litecoin already broke out, so there's a queue for first entry, okay. First entry over here. Then the second entry would be yes, second entry will be here. Okay, 174. The third entry will be 211. Okay. SRP. Well, SRP is very strong on rebound. Okay, we talked about SRP being quite weak, but SRP also broke through. Okay, so if you play SRP, so the first entry re-triggered. Okay, so the second entry is stay above 78. 78 cents, our second entry. So once you break through one ring, $1, so it's our third entry. 1, 2, 3. So remember to subscribe to my channel for you guys, okay, who follow my channel every day. Subscribe, like, and share. Okay, don't forget, support the channel, like, and share. And also subscribe to my channel and anything else, okay, I will put it on my Twitter after the video. So one video every day between 10 to 11 a.m. Singapore time, GMT plus 8. And also Saturday, we have the weekly forecast for the next week of trading. So thank you very much. Thank you for supporting the channel. Thank you for your comment and likes. And stay safe from COVID. Bye bye.